हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ अंकिता शिवेरे एंड टूडेज क्वेश्चन इज बेस्ड ऑन द ट्रिग्नोमेट्री. सो द क्वेश्चन सेज दैट प्रूव दैट टेन ए डिवाइडेड बाय 1 माइनस कॉट ए प्लस कॉट ए डिवाइडेड बाय 1 माइनस टेन ए इज इक्वल्स टू 1 प्लस टेन ए प्लस कॉट ए. वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट एल एच एस इज इक्वल्स टू आर एच एस. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी आर टेकिंग द एल एच एस पार्ट. सो द एल एच एस इज we have to write first of all the LHS part, that is tan A divided by 1 minus cot A plus cot A divided by 1 minus tan A. Now we have to know the value of tan A and cot A. So the value of tan A is sin A divided by cos A, and the value of cot A just reciprocal of the tan A value. So that is the cos A divided by sin A. This will have to know. Now moving toward the LHS part. So putting the value of the tan A and putting the value of the cot A. So tan A is equals to sin A divided by cos A, and the cot value 1 minus cot, that means cos A divided by sin A, plus cot A, that means cos A divided by sin A, denominator 1 minus tan A, that means sin A upon cos A. That is the value of tan A and cot A. We have to just write this value. After that we are just reciprocal of this denominator and multiplying to the numerator. Just reciprocal, just taking the LCM of this part and multiplying with the numerator. So after that sin A divided by cos A, denominator part we are taking the LCM first. So the LCM of 1 minus cos A upon sin A is sin A minus cos A divided by sin A, plus same criteria is follow here. So cos A upon sin A divided by cos A minus sin A divided by cos A. After that just reciprocal of this and multiply with the numerator. So the following are sin A divided by cos A, multiply, just reciprocal of this. So sin A divided by sin A minus cos A so the result are in this format sin A multiply sin A divided by cos A multiply cos A minus sin A. So the required result are sin A divided by cos A multiply sin A divided by sin A minus cos A plus cos A divided by sin A multiply cos A divided by cos A minus sin A. Now we have to multiply these term, that means sin A multiply sin A, that means sin square A divided by cos A sin A minus cos A plus cos multiply cos, that means cos square A upon sin A cos A minus sin A. Now if we are taking this negative sign to there, so that the whole term are very simple. Just like this, if we are taking this minus to there, so that sin A minus cos A, and there is also a sin A minus cos A, so that we are taking a LCM in very simple manner. So we are taking the negative sign to the here. Now साइन ए साइन स्क्वायर ए कॉस ए साइन ए माइनस कॉस ए माइनस दिस मेक जस्ट द एलसीएम सिंपल. सो साइन ए माइनस कॉस ए इट मेक आर एलसीएम जस्ट सिंपल सो दैट वी आर टेकिंग अ नेगेटिव साइन हेयर. नाउ द एलसीएम इज जस्ट गोन अ सिंपल. नाउ मूविंग टूवर्ड द नेक्स्ट स्टेप. Now taking the LCM of this one, so the required LCM are sin A cos A sin A minus cos A. This is the LCM. So after that, here is sin cube A and cos cube A. So the required format are in this format. We have to solve this one. So as you can see, here is sin cube A minus cos cube A. Now there is an identity which we call sin a cube minus b cube. That means a minus b, a square plus b square plus ab. That is the identity which we are use here. Now I am using this identity. So that is the identity. A is sin a and the b part is cos a. So sin a minus cos A sin square A plus cos square A plus sin A cos A divided by sin A cos A sin A minus cos A. So as you can see, the sin A minus cos A and the sin A minus cos A, we are just cancelling this one. This term is just cancelled. And sin square A plus cos square A. The sin square A plus cos square A, that means it is give a value 1. Now we are putting the value 1. So here 1 plus sin A cos A divided by sin A cos A. Now we are just splitting this one. So we are splitting this. 1 is divided by sin a cos a plus sin a cos a is divided by sin a cos a. So after splitting, we are writing just like this. Sin a cos a plus sin a cos a divided by sin a cos a. Now sin a cos a is just cancelled by the sin a cos a and we get a 1. So after that, the LHS part, final LHS part is 1 divided by sin a, that means cosec a. So cosec a and 1 divided by cos a, that means sec a. I am just splitting it just like 1 divided by sin a and 1 divided by cos a. After splitting, we get the value cosec A and the sec A plus 1. So it is the required part LHS. Now we are moving towards the RHS part. We get same result in the RHS part. So after getting toward the LHS, we are moving toward the RHS part. Now moving toward the RHS part, 1 plus tan A plus cot A. 1 plus, what is the value of tan A? Sin A divided by cos A plus cot. The value of cot is cos A divided by sin A. Now I am taking the LCM of this part. So the LCM of this is cos A sin A. Now after taking the LCM, just write it sin A cos A plus the cos is just divided by cos A and we get the value 1. And sin A is just multiplied by the sin A, that means sin square A plus cos square A. Now after that, sin A cos A and sin square A plus cos square A, we get the value 1 by using the identity. Sin square A plus cos square A is equals to 1. So I am putting here 1 and the cos A sin A. Now splitting this one. So after splitting I get sin A cos A divided by sin A cos A plus 1 upon sin A cos A. The sin A cos A and sin A cos A is just cancelled, and after that I have taking this term and splitting this one. So after splitting I get sin A 1 divided by sin A multiply 1 divided by cos A plus 1. So the final result is so hence we get the RHS part cos AK sec A plus 1 and the LHS part cos AK sec A plus 1. That means the LHS is equals to RHS. Hence proved. Now moving toward the another question. The question says that a toy is in a form of hemisphere surmounted by a right circular cone of a same base radius as that of a hemisphere. Learners, the question says that the cone is put over the hemisphere which makes a toy and the same radius of the cone and the hemisphere. As you can see, selected figure which I am making, it is an hemisphere and this is a cone. The cone is over the hemisphere with the same base radius as mentioned in the question, the same base radius of the hemisphere and the cone. The radius of cone is 21 and the radius of hemisphere is also in 21 centimeter. So first of all we are writing the given part, which is radius of cone is 21 centimeter and radius of hemisphere is 21 centimeter. Now apart from this is an height of a cone. Now moving ahead, if the radius of an base of a cone is 21 centimeter and its volume is 2 by 3 of the volume of hemisphere. So learners, what the line says, the volume of cone is 2 by 3 of that of a hemisphere. Volume of hemisphere 2 by 3 of that of the hemisphere. That means volume of cone is the 2 by 3 of that of hemisphere. So volume of cone is equals to 2 by 3 of that of a hemisphere. So now we are just writing this and we have to know what is the volume of cone and what is the volume of hemisphere. So as I am already write the volume of cone and the volume of hemisphere, so just putting this value and we have to find the value of h. So after putting this one, the volume of cone, that is 1 by 3 pi r square h is equals to 2 by 3. It is already mentioned in a question that it is 2 by 3. So 2 by 3 into volume of hemisphere, which is 2 by 3 pi r cube. Now r square and it is an r cube. So it is just cancel out and we have already r. Now 2 by 3 and 1 by 3. So we are just cancelling out 3 to 3. So I have the remaining part is, which we have left is pi h is equals to 2 by 3 multiplied 2 and here is pi multiply r. So as you can see pi is cancelled out by pi. So what we have, h is equals to 2 multiply 2, that means 4 by 3 multiply r. What is the value of r? We already have 21 centimeter. That means it is already given. So 21 centimeter. So what was the value? 7 4 is 28 centimeter. So we have to find the value of h. What was the value of h? We get 28 centimeter. That means the height of cone we get. So the height of cone is 28 centimeter. Now moving toward, calculate the height of cone and the surface area of the toy. We already calculate the height of cone. We already get an height of cone in a previous solution, which is 28 centimeter. Now and the surface area of the toy. So we have to find the surface area of the toy. We have to find the whole surface area of the toy. So the surface area of cone plus surface area, curved surface area of hemisphere, that is pi r l and 2 pi r square. We have to sum these both. So we have to find the surface area of toy. So what was the surface area of toy? The surface area of toy is curved surface area of cone plus curved surface area of hemisphere. It is a surface area of toy. Now, first of all, we have to find out the curved surface area of cone. So the curved surface area of cone is just this one. This part is just a curved surface area of cone, and the curved surface area of hemisphere is just this part. This part is just a curved surface area of a hemisphere, and this part is just a curved surface area of cone, as I am highlighting you. So we have to find the curved surface area of cone first of all. So pi r l. So what was it? We have to put the value of pi, that means 22 by 7, multiply, what was the value of r? 21 centimeter. Multiply, what was the value of l? Now we have to find the value of l. As you can see, here is right angle triangle is formed. So right angle triangle, the value of h we know, the value of r we know. So we have to find the value of l. So by using the Pythagoras theorem, we find the value of l. So first of all, we find the value of l, that means root of r square plus h square. So root of r square, that means 21 square plus h square, that means 28 square. And I am writing the final result 35 centimeter. I am writing the final result 35 centimeter, which is the value of l. We have to find the surface area of a toy. So for a surface area of toy, what we have to do? The curved surface area of cone plus curved surface area of hemisphere. So I am doing surface area of toy is equals to curved surface area of cone plus curved surface area of hemisphere. Fine. So I am writing here the formula of both. That means pi r l plus 2 pi r square. So pi and pi is common, taking common, and r are common. So pi and r both are common. So here what we have to left? L plus 2 r. 1 r is taken and 1 r is here. So what was the value of pi? 22 by 7. Multiply, what was the value of r? That means 21. What was the value of l? That is 35 plus 2 into r, matlab 2 multiply 21. That means we get the final result 5082 centimeter. Moving toward the another question. From the top of 7 meter high building, the angle of elevation of a top of tower is 60 degree and the angle of depression of the foot of tower is 30 degree. So find the height of tower. Basically, I am making the figure. If the question says that from the top of 7 meter high building, that means it is a building that is 7 meter and it is a tower. So as the question say, from the top of 7 meter high building, it is a building and it is a 7 meter high. So the angle of elevation of a top of tower is 60 degree. As you can see, the angle of elevation is making from the 7 meter high building, which is in 60 degree. एंड द एंगल ऑफ डिप्रेशन ऑफ द फुट ऑफ टावर इज 30 degree एंड फ्रॉम द 7 meter हाई बिल्डिंग एंगल ऑफ डिप्रेशन इज मेकिंग विच इज इन 30 degree. सो फाइंड द हाइट ऑफ टावर. वी हैव टू फाइंड दिस एच, कैपिटल एच, द वैल्यू ऑफ कैपिटल एच वी हैव टू फाइंड. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी आर राइटिंग द गिवन पार्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन. सो वॉट वॉज द गिवन पार्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन? 7 meter हाई बिल्डिंग, हाइट ऑफ बिल्डिंग विच इज 7 meter, दैट मीन्स बी डी इज इक्वल्स टू, बी डी इज इक्वल्स टू 7 meter. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस द हाइट ऑफ टावर, सो लेट द हाइट ऑफ टावर, हाइट ऑफ टावर बी कैपिटल एच. नाउ द एंगल वी हैव टू नो. What was the angle? We know this one. So angle ODC is equals to 60 degree, and another angle ODA, that means a 30 degree. These two angle we know. So first of all we are taking this part, that means ODC. ODC we are taking the angle ODC, this triangle ADB, and we have to find the base. So finding the base in triangle ADB, so 10, what was that angle? 30 degree. So 10 30 degree is equals to base upon height, that is 7. So 10 30 degree root 3 b by 7, that means what was the base? Base is equals to 7 root 3. So we get a base 7 root 3. Now taking the another triangle OCD, and we have to find what? The height of a tower. In this triangle, in triangle OCD, 10, what was an angle? 60 degree. 10 60 degree is equals to what base? So h by b. So what was the value of 1060? That is a root 3 h by base. What was the value of base? We are finding 7 root 3. Now h is equals to multiply this to this one, so root 3 multiply root 3 multiply 7. So I get 3 multiply 7, that means a 21. So I get this one, this height, so which is a 21. So by writing h is equals to capital H minus 7, we get the height of tower. As we can find the value of small h, which is in 21, is equals to h minus 7. So we get the height of tower, 21 plus 7 is equals to 28 meter. So that is the height of tower we get. So this is all about the question.